and welcome to this lesson where we are going to go through how to improve your alternate picking as an intermediate-ish guitar player. Before we do that, I'm going to give you the usual YouTube guitar player spiel. So subscribe to my channel, click the bell, follow me on Instagram, like my Facebook page, send me flowers, write some love notes in the sky, yada yada yada, you get the idea. Right, moving on. So there are two sort of main rules you need to think about when you're wanting to improve your alternate picking. One of them gets spoken about a lot by guitar teachers, and it's the importance of synchronisation between your two hands. So that just means if you move your pick across the string, a finger in your fretting hand needs to go down on a fret slightly before that, so you hear the note ringing out nice and clear. What we don't want to be is the kind of guitar player who thinks, I'm going to move this hand up and down as fast as I can, and I'm going to move these fingers as fast as I can, and it's going to make some sort of noise and it's going to be an awesome solo. Because that's not really how it works. That's how you get these kind of noises. I mean, yeah, it does make some sort of noise. It's a bad noise, but it is one. So when guitar teachers talk about this, they are right, it is an important thing, and we can fix that by, you know, using metronomes and playing everything slowly and building up the speed and all that good stuff. But that's not what I'm going to talk about today, because there's another thing that has to come before that, which I think gets overlooked quite a lot, and that is developing actual good mechanics with our picking hand on its own. Because it doesn't matter how much we try to synchronise our two hands, if we've got terrible technique with our picking hand, then we're never going to go anywhere in the first place. So we need to develop good technique with our picking hand before we start worrying about synchronising it up with our fretting hand. Now what I'm also not going to do in this lesson is go through the actual technique points of alternate picking itself. How you hold the pick, how you position your hand, all these sort of things. There's a lot of variables and they're all very unique to the individual. No two great alternate pickers have the exact same technique as one another. So if you want help at figuring out what's going to work for you, you're going to have to come to me for private lessons, I'm afraid. I'm currently teaching on Zoom to people all over the world. Email me about those, link will be in the description. But what I'm going to do is I am going to show you four exercises we can do that are going to improve and establish good technique with our picking hand. So to work on is developing good picking mechanics and good technique with our picking hand, what we're going to do is four exercises that involve tremolo picking. The tremolo picking just means playing lots of notes on one string, or playing one note lots of times, and we're just going to be going down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, forever and ever and ever. The whole idea behind this is that we need to be able to develop good control with our picking hand, so we can play all these notes on one string, because if we can't play loads of stuff with one string, how are we supposed to do lots of complicated picking stuff going between strings? So exercise number one, we're just going to be going through four bars worth of different subdivisions on an open string. It doesn't really matter what string you use, I'm going to use the open high E string to start off, just because it's the easiest. There's no strings below that, so we're not going to run the risk of accidentally hitting anything. So we're going to go through four bars worth of crotchets, or quarter notes, then four bars of quavers, or eighth notes, four bars of quaver triplets, or eighth note triplets, and then finally four bars of sixteenth notes, or semi-quavers. Really quickly, if I just blast through with you how we would count all these, imagine this is your metronome. Crotchets would just be going like 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Eighth notes or quavers would be double that, so we'd be going like ready and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. Quaver triplets would be playing three notes in between every beat, so that would sound like triple it, triple it, triple it, triple it. I can go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And then finally, we're going to play semi-quavers, or 16th notes, which would be four notes per beat, which would be 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. So let's pick a nice slow tempo and we'll go through that together. All right.
Ready, steady, and ready, steady, ready, play.
So that's step one. Step two is we're just going to cut down the amount of time we're doing each subdivision. So instead of doing 4 bars of crotchets, we're just going to do 1 bar. And then instead of 4 bars of quavers, we're just going to do 1 bar. And then we'll do 1 bar of quaver triplets, 1 bar of semi-quavers. And then we'll repeat that pattern a few times round. So we'll go crotchet, quaver, triplet, semi-quaver, crotchet, quaver, triplet, semi-quaver. Right, same tempo. Let's give that a try now.
Ready, steady. And ready, steady, ready, play.
Okay, it's all been quite simple so far. Now we're going to complicate things a bit more. This time we're going to be moving between strings and we're also going to throw our fretting hand into the mix. So we're going to go through all 6 strings for this exercise. Our picking hand is going to stick with the same pattern we had from exercise 1. So we're going to do 4 bars of crotchets, 4 bars of quavers, 4 bars of triplets, 4 bars of semi-quavers. But with our fretting hand, we're going to go onto a different finger for each one of these subdivisions. So again, where you put your hand doesn't really matter. I'm going to start at the 5th fret on the low E string for this, and we would play 4 bars of crotchets to start off with our first finger on fret 5. That sounds like ready and 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then our second finger, we'll go in fret 6. We're going to do 4 bars of quavers. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and... Oh, running out of breath. Right. Then our third finger is going to go on a fret 7. We're going to do 4 bars of triplets. Ready and triplet, 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 triplet. 2 more bars of that, but I can only do so much in one breath. Finally, our pinky will go down on fret 8, and we'll do 4 bars of semi-quavers. Ready and 1e and a 2e and a 3e and a 4e and a 1e and a 2e and a 3e and a 4e and a 2 more bars. Once I've done that, I'm going to go down one string towards the floor, repeat that whole pattern, down a string towards the floor, repeat, and we're going to keep going till we run out of strings and run out of fingers. So let's give that a try now.
Ready, steady, and ready, steady, ready, play. Thank you.
Now, for the fourth version of this exercise, we're going to include the rhythmic idea from exercise 2, as well as the moving between strings and using fingers and our fret and hand idea from exercise 3. So now what we're going to do is just one bar of each subdivision per finger, per string. So first finger at fret 5 in the low E string, one bar of crotchets, 1, 2, 3, 4, second finger on fret 6, one bar of quavers, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, and third finger on fret 7, one bar of triplets, triplet, 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 pinky in fret 8, one bar of semi-quavers, 1 E and a 2 E and a 3 E and a 4 E and a. Then we go on to the next string, repeat, on to the next string, repeat, on to the next string, repeat. Keep going until we run out of fingers and we run out of strings.
Ready, steady, and ready, steady, ready, play.
Congratulations for making it this far. I actually have a fifth and final bonus round for you. Oh, exciting. I know this one's going to be tricky. We're just going to take that same exercise we just did, but now we're going to double up the speed. So instead of playing crotchet, quaver, quaver triplet, semi-quaver, we're going to play quaver, semi-quaver triplet, 32nd notes, which I believe would be called demi semi-quavers, I want to say. Should probably googled that before I filmed this, but I didn't. So, I've also got a wee track for you recorded for this one with some drums and everything. Make it sound fancy, make it sound like music. If you want to download that track, hopefully that should be available on my website, which will be linked in the description as well. So have a wee look at that if you fancy playing along with that. Thank you for watching. I know I said this already, but I'm just going to remind you, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, give the video a like. I'm going to have new ones coming out every other week or so, so make sure you don't miss any of them. Until the next one, happy practicing.